Right, all public schools in the country have reopened for the new school year. The Education Department said as of today, there are no more schools being used as evacuation centers following the devastation left behind by recent Typhoon Karina and the enhanced southwest monsoon. It adds nearly 2,000 schools that sustained damage from the weather disturbance have also been repaired and have reopened. Pag-asa is monitoring three low-pressure areas. One is already inside the Philippine area of responsibility. Here's a question. How will this affect weather conditions in the country? Let's find out from ABS-CBN resident meteorologist Ariel Rojas. Ariel?
Hi, good afternoon, Carmina. Not one, not two, but three low-pressure systems surround the country. As you mentioned, the first LPA is inside the Philippine area of responsibility, some 565 kilometers northeast of Itbayat, Batanes. The second one is just north of the PAR, more than 700 kilometers east-northeast of Batanes. And these two systems may eventually merge, but chances of developing into a storm remain low. The third LPA has higher chance of forming into a tropical cyclone, but it's more than 2,000 kilometers from extreme northern Luzon and will continue to move away from the country. These three weather disturbances do not directly affect the country but will slightly enhance the southwest monsoon or Habagat until the weekend. Habagat rains are prevailing over Pangasinan, central Luzon, Mindoro, and Romblon. Thunderstorms are also expected later over Cordillera, Calabarzon, Bicol region, western Visayas, Negros region, northern Mindanao, Caraga, and Sokcerjen. Metro Manila, of course, is not spared from the occasional rains from Habagat and thunderstorms. That's the latest on the weather. This is Ariel Rojas. Back to you, Carmina.
Thanks a lot, Ariel Rojas, there joining us live. As Philippine inflation breaching government's 2-4% target range for the first time since November last year. The Statistics Bureau said the consumer price index was at 4.4% in July, higher than June's 3.7%, but lower than last year's 4.7%. Year-to-date, average inflation is at 3.7%, still on track to meet government's target. The PSA attributes the increase to rising utility and food prices. Despite this, at least one economist believes inflation will soon decrease in the coming months, thanks to government's reduction in tariff rates for imported rice.
I think what we haven't seen here in the July print yet is the impact of the reduction of import tariffs of rice. I expected that to start materializing and showing up in the August print. This doesn't take into account the impact of rice tariff reductions. Just based on my current estimates, we are probably going to see headline inflation going down to around 2% by the end of the year, maybe even slightly lower, like 1.7, 1.8. So it's a fairly big drop from 4.4 in July.
The discovery of over 8,000 fake birth certificates issued to foreign nationals proves the Senate scrutiny of fugitive Bamban Mayor Alice Go is bearing fruit. That's according to Senator Riza Ontiveros, who says government needs to review its processes in issuing important documents. Ontiveros believes Go's case is not isolated, especially in the hometown of former President Rodrigo Duterte.
We were reasonable in worrying habang iniimbestiga si Guo Huaping o Mayor Alice Guo, worrying about nag-iisa lang ba siya or are there others? Panahon ni Duterte, nag-open door policy, may EO tungkol sa POGOs. And then we find out that there's this proliferation of fake birth certificates mula din sa home region niya. And we have to get to the bottom. Gaano ba kalaki, kalawak, ka-interrelated itong buong POGO phenomenon? And how have the disruption or the distortion of government agencies and government processes tulad ng dapat regular na pag-i-issue ng birth certificates been used para pahigpitin yung kapit ni Duterte at ng mga kasosyo niya sa negosyo at sa politika sa ganitong mga pagkasangkapan ng government institutions and procedures.
Ontiveros also believes Duterte's ally and former spokesman Harry Roque has links to illegal POGOs.
nakapagtataka talaga sa dinami-dami ng bahay dito sa bayang Pilipinas, dun pa talaga sa sinasabing bahay niya natagpuan yung fugitive na yan. And again, that fugitive is identified by PAOK as the IT manager of Lucky South 99, which is the POGO company na inaareglo ni Attorney Roque. It seems that Attorney Roque and the people of Lucky South 99 are running in the same circles. That is really the subject of intense investigation on the part of my committee.